Hi everyone, we're coming to you from Swift Reservoir in Southwest Washington. It's winter rainbow fishing. The last 2 months of the season here at Swift, they upped the rainbow limit to 10 and the fishing can be off the charts. We're going to be fishing today with Luke Hatfield and his dad John. They're local anglers who know this lake well. They're going to show us some really cool techniques and spots to catch these fish. So let's go fishing.
Hello, just getting the gear put together to get out. So we're allowed 10 fish per angler. So in a perfect world, we're gonna put 50 fish in the cooler today.
One of the things that caught my eye on a report that Luke put out on Northwest Fishing Report's Facebook page is a dual setup. Luke, explain how this works.
So we're using a Mitsuo 9 to 12 foot suspended diving shad representation. It's our diver. It's going to take it down approximately 9 feet with the amount of line out that we have. And we're pulling behind it either a crippler like this or a dick knight spoon, which is the primary thing that's going to be hit. But we have had a couple of big fish that have been taking the swim bait along the way.
So you've got this line coming off
yep.
to the side. And have you ever hooked two fish at once with this setup?
I have not yet. But that's the goal.
but it could happen. So
and
maybe
we're three hook legal. You got one here and two on here. So if you go to a bigger swim bait, you might have to take a hook off to run that setup.
But. Okay, so street legal.
Yep.
And a deadly combination.
It has been out here, yes.
Excellent. Luke, you pulled this lure out, and it kind of looks like a super duper, but it's not. What is this?
That's a Shasta tackle crip lure. It's a mouthful.
Shasta tackle, which is of course now a max lure.
Yep. And it's called the crip lure. Out here at Swift, the area that I like to fish, you don't burn up a lot of fuel. You start right at the boat launch. It's about 25 feet of water, tapering off to 40 as the shelf comes out of this bay. From the 40 foot, it drops down to about 50, tapering into 70 and then 100 foot. But basically from north to south mid lake, and from the boat launch to about an eighth of a mile past the island on the south side. The old river channel goes through there, and for whatever reason the fish are associating to it, whether it be water temperature, food coming in from the creek feeds that are getting funneled into it, I don't know, but they're right in that mid zone and they're right on the surface.
Another good day of fishing with NWFR.com.
I'll do the honor. Fish on, first of the day.
Go to my fish manager.
Yeah. Oh,
grab
him. Nice.
For fish identification, this is actually one of the coho, I believe. See how the
yep.
fork is in the tail there?
Yep.
So we're allowed the coho up to 15 inches, but not over. So he will count as part of our 10 trout daily limit.
This guy will smoke up just fine. A lot of hazards out there, huh, Randy?
There he is. You don't put the throttle to the wall on this lake.
Oh, there's fish. There's fish.
Right there, grab it. Give it a good pop. There you go.
You got this one, Robbie?
I hope so.
I'm going to rock about another fish on right here.
Fish on. You're down.
Here
you go. Got a double.
There you go.
There's one in the boat.
Another coho.
We'll get it up.
There we go.
We're going to double dip the fish, get him up close to the surface. Two on the net.
Yeah.
And that's why I wanted to have a couple of nets to be a little
right. Don't pull on that. Thank you.
Oh, no.
Put eyes on it. Oh, there he is. He's coming.
Nice fish, Randy.
Oh, it's a monster.
It's a monster.
It's Moby Kokanee. Moby Coho.
Yeah. And he is clipped. Another one on the crip lure.
Fish.
Yep.
There I got
go,
it.
There
I got
go.
It.
Nice fish.
Oh my goodness.
This is fishing.
Are there some fish here or what?
Yeah.
Holy cow.
I love that organized chaos.
Oh, yeah.
That's out. I'll hold on.
And another two in the net.
That's already up.
Quick release.
I'll take the net. Ooh, I didn't check him for a fin, but I think they're both done.
Both clipped.
So we're checking to make sure these fish are clipped. Because if they're not, we got to go back. John, you got the big fish of the day so far, and that's on an old goat lure.
A nice speckled crab.
Yeah.
So those old goat lures are 3D printed, the latest technology in lure manufacturing. Awesome idea.
And made locally by a guy here in Washington.
Yep.
Very cool.
Fish. Got it, Robbie.
nice fish.
All right. Go get him. Nice promise.
Might dip into a grab this. I know you called it.
And you're a...
Swim out just a little bit more if you can.
Yeah, fish thief.
No, he hit the swim bait too.
Oh!
You slacklined me, Robbie.
Sorry.
Ouch. That's the
he was on the tail hook of that swim bait.
You farmed it, Robbie.
My bad.
Good fish, Mike? Maybe.
You can't. I'm gonna have to drop that release tension down to the bottom. There's there.
Fish on the planer board. There we go. The hop bite continues. Is it?
It's a cripple lure. It's in his mouth pretty good.
So this guy's on a cripple lure. Mac Lure product, Shasta Lures.
Nice looking fish.
Very nice. Nice job, Robbie. Good job finessing that fish.
Yes. Without a tangle.
That's a beautiful fish.
Without a tangle.
You got the fork in the tail? Yep. Nice go.
I was going to bounce me.
Yeah, I know. I didn't want Robbie to get pitched.
I'd say coho.
Yeah.
It's been really productive this morning, Luke.
It's been
hot bite.
It has, hot and nice and steady. I think we're coming up on 30 fish. We still got another 20 to go.
Yep. The fish are here, we'll get them.
They definitely are here. And surprisingly, not too many tangles on these five lines running.
No, we only had the one fish run two lines and we got out of that pretty quick, so it hasn't been terrible.
Yep. So, all right, well, we're getting rained on again, so back to fishing.
All right.
Crazy. Just to get a good
shot. That's a good sized fish. He's pulling that planer underwater.
Yeah.
Might be the fish of the trip.
Yep. Do you want to start backing up just a little bit?
Up a little bit.
Got it.
Old goat.
Old goat.
Old goat.
Old goat.
People should be buying more old goats.
Old goat lures. Doing the job here on Swift Reservoir. It's danger zone.
We got some bite to him. That's a nice fish. You pull him out. Give me a little lift. Got it.
Oh, thank you. Rainbow.
And are you clipped? He's clipped.
Another fish, Mike?
Another fish. We're getting into a lot of the coho now. This is pretty cool.
There it is.
Planer board. There's a fish. Feels like a good fish. It's been a good day.
These are both coho.
Oh, two coho?
Yep.
Some of the other lakes, the landlocked coho, are kind of skinny and motley looking. These are beautiful fish.
Good fishing.
Luke, you promised us fish and you came through.
I did my best and the fish cooperated. If you ever get a chance to fish the fall segment of the Swift Reservoir trout and coho fishery, take a chance. Most days it's all you can do to keep them off your lines.
Yeah, that's amazing. Five guys, five limits, 50 fish. Check out Swift Reservoir. It closes end of November, so come on out and get them next year. We'll see you guys on the water and online.
Thanks, Luke.